Morning guys, hope everyone's okay. I'll wait for you to start jumping on. Happy Easter to everyone. So we are doing the adults. Thank you to Mr. Crump for his last class. Just give us a thumbs up when you're on, guys. Helen, are you all right, love? Joel, you good? I'll give you all a close-up of the beard in a moment. Just tying my belt. Put your hand up if you've got a hangover, adults. I've seen a lot of people out drinking yesterday in the gardens. Let me know if the sound's all right as well, guys, please. Helen, you all right, love? Zachary, look, my brother, me and you are brothers. Yeah, man. You like it, Zach? Apparently, I got an inbox off Mr. Diaz last night. He thinks it suits me, so he wants me to keep it. Just comment and let me know if the sound's all right. Stop moving that about. Don't know if it's coming through or not. Make sure you've got a drink as well, guys. You see, Smith Dog's just jumped online. You alright, Katie? So yeah, this is sort of the final look of what it's going to be. It's gone a little bit light. I put some toner on it last night. Slightly burnt my face underneath. It's a little bit sore. There is a little bit of dye left, so if I get a chance today, I might stick the rest of the dye on it and see if it goes a little bit brighter and put some pictures on. But make sure you tune in tonight because Jack's doing his hair tonight. So that'll be fun to watch anyway. Alright. Let me just see if the camera's alright. Yeah, we're good. Alright guys, do you want to gain some space, get a drink? Do some combinations, some level changes, transitioning from punches into kicks. I did like a breakdown for the ninjas, a slow breakdown with the ninjas last week. Finley, you all right, mate? Tony, we all good, brother? I'm just saying, you like my beard, so I don't know if I'm going to keep it or not, since as you like it, so I might actually keep it, mate, to be honest. We'll see what happens. So, yes, if you tune in, me and Jack were talking last night, and we have got a challenge for Tony and Craig this week that they can do at home, so that'll be fun to watch. And obviously, because they're legends, they're not going to back out of it, and they will do it. Not a problem. And it's going to be fun to watch. I'm going head to head. Right, guys, so have a great Easter. All right, so let's kick off, well, start today with, like I said, we're going to do basic combinations, transitioning from punches into kicks. Things like that, and then at 12 o'clock, I think it's 12 o'clock, Tony's doing a Zoom workout, all right? So if you've not seen it on Facebook yet, Tony's gonna do a Zoom workout. So if you wanna be hardcore on Sunday and work out before you start eating and drinking, guys, all right, jump onto that Zoom class because it'll be absolutely brilliant. So from here, guys, feet together, and bow, burst. Start jogging on the spot. And star jumps, please. And lunges. sort this music out in here. The music's shocking. Craig's iPad. Squats. Well done, all the way down, keeping that back nice and straight. And bring those knees up. Keep bringing them nice and high.
Leanne, you all right? I hope you're well.
Bring those knees up, guys, up to the side. Shake them out. Up to the front. Any of you that have got BT, if you go onto the sports bit, there's a Joe Calzaghe documentary listing all of his fights and like interviews with him and his dad. It's really a good watch if you're struggling for things to watch. He was my favourite boxer, so it was a nice little find last night on BT. So if you're into your boxing or just want to watch something on it, Joe Calzaghe documentary is on there. And shake them off. And from there into sit up position, guys.
Morning, Chantel. Happy Easter.
So, knees bent, legs crossed. Sit ups, let's go. Rest, 10 seconds. You're gonna do sit-ups with a single twist. So going one side, then go the other, guys. Ready? Let's go. Rest. Right, you're going to do extensions, so you're going to come up, reach up to the ceiling, and back down. You're not going to use your arms for momentum, though. Just reach up and back down. Ready? Let's go. And rest up on your feet. Big deep breaths. Right, take your arms forward for me. And back. Kicking your legs out. Just keep moving on the spot so you don't go stiff. Arms out to the sides. And legs apart. Just go down to your left hand side. Change. 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 There, we're just going to do side lunges, guys, just to open our legs up a little bit because we are going to be doing some kicking. Ready? Off we go. And shake them off. All right, grab a quick drink. We're gonna start with content. So work our hands and legs. Minimum of three shot combinations, all right, so I'm going to put them together. So the combination we're going to do, you're not going to do this to my count. We're going to do this for a minute, all right, minute rounds, this first section. So get the combination, we're going to walk through it together, then I'm going to start the timer. You're going to be on your toes, hitting the combination for full 60 seconds. We'll have a 15 second rest, and then you're going to do it again for a set for 30 seconds afterwards. So you'll be doing it for a minute and a half rounds, all right? With a little bit of a break in between, but I want you always bouncing. Right, the combination that we're going to do, nice and simple to start with. Lead arm, you're going to step in with your jab, rear body hook, back leg, front kick. Nice and simple there. So you're transitioning from body, back up, pushing that leg through. So from here, go high with the first shot. We're dipping into these knees, so you dip and roll at the same time to generate that power. You're not swinging this arm everywhere. So you're going to dip, roll and strike from here. Then pull forwards, push that front kick straight through. So from this side, I hit the jab, we're gonna dip and roll, there. As soon as I've hit that shot, I'm pulling straight forward with that front kick, all right? So let's go through it together, then we'll start the time. So from here, jab, body hook, front kick, back down, bounce around on my toes, all right? So count to two in your head before you go and re-engage on that second shot, all right? So from here, jab, body hook, front kick, on our toes, bouncing round, then go again. Jab, body hook, front kick, on your toes, bouncing round again, okay? Get ready. Joe Hardacre, how you doing, my man? Hope you're well. Happy Easter. Ready. So a minute, 15 second rest, and then we're gonna do it for 30 seconds after that. Ready, in your guards, bouncing. Let's go. Nice and fluid. Lift. Moving round. Lift. 20 seconds in. Lift. Nice and loose, nice and relaxed. Lift. And time, shake it off. Big deep breaths, recover. We're gonna go again for 30 seconds. Ready. Let's go. Lift. Lift. 5 seconds. Lift. Time. Into sit-ups. Let's go. And up on your feet, grab a drink, well done. Big deep breath, shake it off. Get a quick drink. We're into combination number two. And this time, right. So this time I want you to imagine that someone's coming at you this time, all right? So we're gonna hit with a counter shot. So if someone's coming at you, then you're gonna engage with your technique. So the combination is going to be, I want you to imagine they're coming forward at you with hand strikes. So what you're going to do is you're going to slip slightly. So as you slip, you're going to throw the uppercut at the same time. So it's not going to be two movements where we slip, come back and hit. What you're going to do is slip. As you have slipped, use it. So if you watch, I'll do it on my knees first. So watch my back shoulders as I do this. So if I'm seeing a punch coming at me, what I'm going to do from here, I'm going to slip and dip at the same time. So I'm dipping my shoulder. So I don't have to slip, dip, roll and go up. I'm going to do it all in one motion. So we go off to the side and dip that back shoulder. So it's there. Then I'm going to roll straight up with that uppercut. All right. So I'm hitting it straight away. So from here, off, roll, up here. All right. So when I'm in my stance, see the shot come in. I slip and dip at the same time. I'm bending that back leg slightly a little bit more. I'm dipping down into that stance. You're going to roll up with an uppercut. Then what you're going to do is push forwards with a jab cross and a front kick on the end of that, all right? So you're driving them back. You hit them with the uppercut through the guard, drive them back with your two straights, and then finish them with a rear leg to the stomach or chest, all right? So from here, so if we're all together, so if we're all getting our stance, slip and dip at the same time, so we're there. So it's that motion there. Then roll straight up with the uppercut coming through the guard, aiming for the chin, there. Then from here, drive forwards. One, two, in with the front kick. So if I'm sideways on here, I'm going to dip and roll, hit, one, there. Jab, cross, front, reset. Okay, one more time. So imagine a straight shot's coming at you. You slip and dip at the same time, roll up with that shot, push forwards, engage that front kick, and then disengage, reset. So I'll have a practice at that now, ready? So let's slip and dip, roll, hit with the uppercut. Jab, cross, front kick, push back out. All right, that's our combination again. We're gonna go for a minute, 15 seconds rest, then we'll go for an extra 30 seconds and finish with the next side. Big deep breaths. Ready? Nice and loose. Let's go. Nice and relaxed, nice and fluid. A little bit of movement in that body. Good, well done. 30 seconds in. And time, rest, big deep breaths. Ooh, it's warm in here. Got a dab on. Morning, Kay. Happy Easter. Hope you're good. Oh, ready, guys. So back into it. 30 seconds, and we're doing 30 seconds of exercises. Ready? Let's go. Time, shake them out. Right, we're gonna go into squats, guys, okay? But what I want you to do, when you're in the squat down position, I want you to hold it for 2 seconds, then we're gonna come back up, all right? So ready? Do it with me. And down. 1, 2, up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and bring it back up again. Shake those legs off. Right, grab a quick drink. Oh, I'm sweating today. So, write some nice comments about the beard. If I get enough people that say they like it, I might keep it, you know. Might keep it this colour and keep re-dyeing it. Something a little bit different. So, if you like it, leave a comment. But if I get more likes than not likes, I might keep it this colour and carry on dyeing it ginger. Just for the laugh for a little bit. Right, so what I'm going to do now, I've had some really good feedback on the breaking down of techniques, alright? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to break down two kicks for you now. We're going to do, and these will be to my count. So I'm going to break down the hook kick, and I'm going to break down the spinning hook kick, obviously, because it sort of follows on. Alright, so this is how I got to, how I break this down is really how I got taught it myself. Alright, I find it the easiest way, and it sort of clicked in my head when I got taught it this way. Because there's a lot of things go wrong with people that sometimes when they're trying to do a hook kick, there's little mechanics that if it's not right, then it won't go right. So some of the big things that I want you to do, so if we get into our stance now, the first thing that you need to do is pivot this lead leg. So it goes all the way out, so you twist it all the way out there, and this opens up your hips. Your chamber position should be the same as a side kick, so fully on. So you fully rotate round, and your knee should be in front of you there, pointing the other way, sideways on, there, all right? From here then, I'm gonna do it really low, so I can do it slow for you. Then from here, imagine that there's a box in front of you, yeah? So imagine there's a box where your target is. Your foot has to go from this side of the box, clean straight through to the other side, and then that's when you whip your leg back in. Sometimes, if you find that your hook kick's going up, or it's coming down, that's because your leg position's wrong, your chamber position's wrong. If you find that you're falling off balance, you'll be over twisting and leaning too far back. So drop the height of the hook kick, all right? So from here, we're gonna twist this front foot. That knee comes up there in a side kick chamber position. Then all you do from there is extend your leg, point your toes, and you whip it round, and then bring your heel back to your bum as quick as you can, and then put it back down. So when you do it, it should look up, extend, point those toes all the way out, whip it, bring the heel back in, and you place it back down. So then when you do it to either bod, head, or chest height, it should look like that, and you're coming back in, so you're hooking and sweeping it across, all right? So we're gonna do 10 on one leg, and then I'll do a spinning hook kick as well, all right? So they're getting to your stances, and again, with techniques, I honestly do drill techniques at home. Even when I'm in a train, I will literally just stand there, I'll pop jabs out. I'll practice all my kicks off both legs. All right, and I do drill, so don't just think that instructors say you need to drill it. We do practice, well I do anyway, all right? So I do practice, so even if you've got a spare 10 minutes, just practice your kicks. And like the kicks that you're struggling with, these are what will break down, and you can sort of do it bit by bit, and then just practice them and get them better, all right? So from here, we're gonna do 10 hook kicks, so making sure your guard's up. So we'll do it in three stages first. Number one, let's twist our foot. Number two, let's bring that knee up. Number three, let's sweep across, there. And bring it back, all right? We'll do two like that. So ready? Twist that front foot outwards. Bring that knee up into that position. And from there, let's extend it and whip it as quick as we can in the straight line. There, and put it back down there. All right, one more time like that. So broken down, pivot that front foot outwards. Let's bring that knee up, then sweep it straight across as quick as we can. There, all right? And that's how to break it down into three stages. Now we're gonna do all in one go. Paul Lynch, happy Easter. Hope you're well, my man. All right, so that's how I break it down into three little bits. So we twist, we bring that chamber up, and then you're gonna sweep across as quick as you can, and then put behind. All right, so if you're struggling with that kick, break it down into those three stages, then take a stage out. So to break it down a little bit more, you can twist and bring your knee up, that can be number one, and then number two, just extend and whip and put back down, all right? So now we're gonna do 10, just my count all together. Do it at your own pace, guys, but listen, this is a kick that I've been asked to break down, so I'm going to do it, so just take your time with it. So we'll do 10, then we'll move on, but keep drilling it after class, all right? So from here, in our guards, we're going to do 10 hook kicks. Ready? One. Two. Nice and fast whip as soon as you get out. Make sure you're extending that leg straight out. Ready? Three. Four. Reach with it, extend that hip through. Five. Six, keeping that guard up. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Well done. All right, shake that leg off. So that was a hook kick. Now, for the spin, again, the delivery is exactly the same, just adding a spin on. Now, I've done this with a back kick. How I see people doing this wrong is the kick, you release the kick, some people release this kick too quick. So they'll start kicking from here, and then that spin looks like that, all right? Overstepping or understepping. So I've done this with a back kick. When you're stepping slightly, don't overstep this kick here. But one, you're gonna let people know what you're doing, so you telegraph it to bring your leg round to get momentum. It's a tiny little movement. So from here, just step slightly there. Step across slightly then, twist those hips here. Bring that knee up, and then it's exactly the same as a hook kick. So just break it down into those little steps there. So from here, step across slightly, do a full twist, look over that shoulder, then here, chamber up, and release at the same time, all right? From here, step across, twist, chamber, extend, and kick out, all right? Now let's take a step out. So we're gonna twist and chamber at the same time. So step, twist, chamber, from here, there, up, release, and back again. So step, twist, chamber, and then release at the last minute, ready? Step, twist, chamber, release, and back round. Now, put it all together. Then when you get really, really confident, you can just twist on the spot and go from there. All right, but to break it down to make you more confident, add in that tiny little step just to get your body across, okay? Now a spinning hook kick is a really, really, it's used a lot, especially in defensive when you're fighting kickers, if it's light con, or point, more points than light con, but especially when you get people firing this leg at you, a lot of people like to spin and try and catch them out with it, all right? So it is a good defensive technique as well. It can be used that way instead of attacking as well. So from here, we'll do 8 of these. So nice and steady, again, in your own pace. So step across, twist, making sure you release that hook kick when you're fully twisted round. So you're not releasing it halfway round. And that's why the kick's not coming all the way in front of you, okay? Right, in your own time, ready? 1, 2, 3, keeping your balance, not like that, 4, 5, 6, well done, and then once you feel confident, try and spin straight on the spot, so take that step out, try and spin on yourself here, so in, twist and hit there, all right, we'll do 3, ready? 1, 2, 3, well done, shake off those legs. All right, we'll do one more, so we'll do a combination. Again, do this, we're gonna do it for a minute, 15 seconds rest, and I'll hit you with 30 seconds at the end, all right? So we started off with drilling combinations. I got asked to break down, I've been inboxed a couple of times to break down those. So I've just broken down a kick, a spinning hook kick, and I'll just finish with a nice little burnout combination, all right? So again, a minute, 15 seconds rest, 30 seconds to finish, okay? So from here, I'll do it sideways on. Pop forward this double jab, there, all right? And again, do not be lazy with this. Again, if, with a jab, it's a gateway shot to everything. If it's lazy, the rest of it won't work. You're just gonna get caught, or your opponent's gonna disengage, move, I'll just smash you up because you're being lazy with that lead arm. Okay, so this has to pop out nice and fast, not this. All right, comes all the way back, retract it, step and push. 1, 2, nice and sharp there, going forward to set up. You're gonna hit a cross punch, and then just a lead body hook, there, all right? Dip in and roll in, so from here, pop forward with this lead arm. 1, 2, hit the cross, twist. As I twist, again, the weight, and I've dipped down slightly to roll and drive up with this body hook. From there, I want you to disengage, move off, and then reset to go again. All right, so we're here, double jab, 1, 2, cross punch, then hit in with that hook, disengage, moving off. All right, always keeping these arms up, but I want this jab, this double jab, nice and sharp. If it's lazy, the rest of this combination doesn't work, because you either get countered, or they're just gonna move off. All right, so you have to be nice, direct, and aggressive with this jab, okay? Ready, minute, 15 second rest, and 30 seconds to finish. Ready? Go. Nice and fluid. again. Put some fakes in if you like before you throw. Seconds in. No gaps in between shots. And time, shake them out. Well done. Last 30 seconds, guys. Ooh. It's warm in this gym. Ready? 30 seconds to finish. Let's go. Whoosh. And time. Shake them off. Well done, guys. Right, start taking your arms forward. Keep moving on the spot. And back. Swing your arms back. Right, so like I said before, Tony Diaz is doing a Zoom class, 12 o'clock, Easter workout. So if you're gonna be hardcore before you start eating chocolate and having a drink, then tune into that, change sides. 7 o'clock, Jack Rhodes bleaches his hair. So tune in for that one. Push it forwards. And lean forwards, keeping those legs nice and straight. Well done. Up on your feet, shake them off. Hip rotations, 5 one way, 5 the other. Well done, change. And good, shake them all out. Right guys, enjoy Easter as best as you can. So if you're at home with the kids, family, whatever, have a lovely, lovely day. All right, hopefully we're gonna get weather like we did yesterday. It's nice and warm for you. If you're doing the other training sessions, have a great, great time. So I know Tony's gonna put on a really good one. All right, and then if you wanna laugh like you laughed at me last night, dye on my beard, tune in and see Jackie Boy do his hair, all right? Last time me and Jack are gonna be doing forfeits. The other instructors are gonna start doing them now because me and Jack's had enough. All right, so from here, have a good one. Stay safe, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in and being with me on Easter. Feet together. Bow. Us. See you all later, guys. Thank you.